Hello everyone, welcome to the first episode of this series, The Era of VTuber, Building One with Python and Unity. So this series will be introducing how to create your own VTuber motion tracking system, which is able to run on a laptop with an integrated graphic card only with Python and Unity. So in the first episode, we will be introducing the motion detection and tracking system, or in other words, the post estimation system built with Facemesh, this new released and astonishing library. So if you're interested in this project, the link of the GitHub is in the description and you can check it out for all the source code and the sample Unity project as well. So make sure you check it out and you have also some features and some introduction of the project post here. So before kicking off the episode, I have to make some disclaimer first. So the first one, the video or the whole series will target people with some experience in coding only, but not completely beginners. So like if you're a beginner in Python and you want to learn Python, so you have to check out other beginners tutorial, like how to declare some variables, the flow of control, and other stuff. And also, this video or the whole series is not a step-by-step guide or step-by-step tutorials that types every line of the code throughout the video. Or otherwise, the whole series will be extremely long, like 30 minutes of each episode, and I will be very tired. Instead, this video will only display the code and just explain some of the key steps and the concepts of the code, so you will be more comfortable while reading the code. And you can grab a copy of the code from my GitHub page. So in this project, we will be using two tools. The first one is Python, and the second one is Unity. And the numbers in the bracket will be the version that I've been using while developing this project. So in Python, we'll be using some computer vision packages like MediaPipe and OpenCV to build the post estimation system, the face and its landmark detection. And we'll be using this to calculate the rotation of your head and other facial expressions like the eye aspect ratio, the mouth aspect ratio, and other facial expressions to control the avatar. And we will be using Python as well to transmit the results to Unity using the TCP protocol. And in Unity, we will be using this tool to host our 3D or live 2D model and we'll run them in our computer as well. And we'll be interpreting the results that sent from the Python to control the movement and the animation of these characters, like the head rotation, the blinking, and the mouth movements as well. So in the first part of this video, we'll be introducing some concepts, and the second part of the video, we'll be talking about the code review of my project that related in this episode. So building a facial motion tracking system is equivalent to doing the post estimation of your face, which involves three steps. So there are the first one, you have to detect any face as well. You have to detect whether in your camera or in your image has any face. And the second one, we have to detect the landmarks, the facial landmarks. And the first one, we have to estimate your pose or the pose estimation. So the first two steps will be done by the MediaPipe library instead of the dlib library, the more prevalent library used in any other projects and in some of the papers as well. So MediaPipe, the new library made by Google here, will provide some excellent, some accurate, and some GPU standard face detection and landmark detection using the CPU only. So like I said before, the project can be run in CPU only thanks to this library, providing 30 FPS smooth detection. And moreover, it supports cross-platform, so you can develop your project or deploy your project for Android, for iOS, and even for web page using the JavaScript one here. And you can see that the Facemesh library provides a tremendous amount, 468 landmarks in 3D form, and the green lines here are showing the landmarks that detected and generated by the Facemesh library, and you can see it's running smooth. So the first step, so we have solved the first two steps, and the first step we will be using the solve PNP function in OpenCV for estimating the translation and rotation method of your head. And the function basically takes two inputs. The first one is the 2D pixel coordinates of all landmarks in this image. So you're using this image as an example, it will input all the landmarks that are located on the 2D image, the pixel coordinates of all the landmarks 2D image. And the second one will be the 3D coordinate of all landmarks on a 3D canon new face model. So like the example will be here, and you have a face model here, and each of the landmarks is located on the face model and will be called its 3D coordinate of all landmarks. So you have to input these two things as well as other data, but other data are more important than these two data. So we'll take these two data as our main input, and the function will return two vectors. So the first one is the rotation vector, and the second one is the translation vector. So the rotation vector will record how your head rotates based on the camera rotation. So it will set the camera rotation as 0, 0, 0, and by multiplying the rotation vector, it will get your head rotation. And the second is the translation vector. It will record how your head positions based on your camera's coordinate. So the position of the cameras will be 0, 0, 0 in the 3D space, and by multiplying with the vector, but the translation vector will get your position of your head in the virtual 3D space. So here we will be interested in the rotation vector only, because we have to do this kind of the rotation, and this kind of rotation can be calculated from the rotation vector. So you can also change the algorithm to make use of the translation vector to perform more movement to your 3D or live 2D model. So you can shake your shoulders, move your whole body, or move the upper part of your body using the translation vector. Then the data will be passed to a stabilizer, which in here will be using the Kalman's filter to stabilize the values, or otherwise your models will be, otherwise the values is so fluctuated that your model will be shaking tremulously, and by using a stabilizer, the value will be more stable and will provide a smoother result so that your model won't have any exaggerated movements. And lastly, we'll convert the rotation vector to the roll pitch your format. It's just like the rotation X, Y, Z set in the Unity, and so in the rotation vector, each of the column will represent one of the parameters. So if you move up and down of your head, will be using the pitch one, and you're moving like this to this, you're using the roll, and you're moving this to this is the yaw motion. So the picture here is from the GitHub page right here. After introducing the main concepts, we'll be doing the code review of the whole project. So we'll jump to the code here. So we'll be doing from the facial landmark file, and we're doing the pose estimator file following the procedures mentioned before, and last we'll analyze the main program. So here the stabilizer script is just a direct copy from this project, and you use Kalman's filter as a point stabilizer to stabilize a 2D point or a 2D value or a scalar as well. So we'll start with the facial landmark one. So here we'll wrap the media pipe face mesh library into a separate class so that we can reuse this class or this project in your other size project. So initialize some of the variables, and we'll initialize the face mesh library here and pass in all the parameters. So you can change the default one by passing a separate value. And we'll also initialize some of the drawing utilities used by the media pipe library to draw the facial landmark like here. We're using the drawing utilities provided by the face mesh library. So the first two steps is done by the find face mesh function. So we'll first converting the image, reflecting the image by the vertical axis to provide a mirroring effect, and we'll pass in here this line will pass the image to the face mesh detector process function and get back the results here. So here we also declared a array to store the detected results, to store the pixel coordinates of each faces detected by the face mesh detector. So here we're checking if there are any results. So if there are results for each of the faces in the results, then we'll get all of the 468 points pixel coordinates of each landmark, and we'll append it to a separate array, and last the array will be appended to the main faces array here. And so if draw is set to true, then you draw the facial landmark on your image, and last you return the processed image and the array that stores all the landmarks of each of the detected face here. And the main function here will just a sample one of the module above. So the second part is the step three, which is the pose estimation, and here we'll initialize the post estimator. So, like I said before, the soft PNP function takes in the 3D coordinates of all landmarks on a 3D panel CO model. So you store these models in a separate text file, the model TXT here. So for every three lines, will be the X, Y, Z coordinates of each spatial landmark. And the model.txt, the source one, can be found right here. The link is in the end of the web page here, the OBJ one here. Okay, where the model.txt is also included in the GitHub as well. So we have to declare some of the camera's internal values, like the camera ray trace and the distortion coefficients for the sake of the soft PNP function. It also takes in these two parameters, but these are some of the less important parameters than the 3D model points and the 2D pixel coordinates of each of the landmarks. So we'll get all these points using this function, and the main function, the third function, the third procedure of the full post estimation procedure. So we're calling the soft PNP function, and we return the rotation vector and the translation vector, just as simple as that. So here will be we can draw the axis, we can draw the estimated axis of the estimated post here using the draw axis function here. And so basically you get the 3D, you get the red, blue, and the green line here, like the axis, the X, Y, Z axis of your head. So at last, we'll go through the main function, the main program of in the main.py, in the main.py file. So here, we'll using the OpenCV to capture the video of your webcam here. And we'll also initialize the face mask detector and the pose estimator. And the pose estimator needs the shape of the, needs the height and the width of your image. So we have to capture a sample frame from the for the post estimation initialization process. And here we'll introduce some scalar stabilizers of the Kalman filter. So here while the camera is opened, and we'll read the image from the camera, and we'll do the first two steps by calling the find.facemesh function. And here we'll also fit the image in the main function, because the image is fit in the find.facemesh function only, but not the main function. And the first step is to solve all points, to solve PNP function to the post estimation. And here we'll be ensuring that we only get the first phase, because we have only one host, one Unity host to host the model. But if you have a separate one, you can get more than one phase, just change here. And at last, we'll be stabilizing the calculated values using the stabilizers. And here, we'll be converting the rotation vector to the raw pitch UR format. So here, the rotation vector is in radian, and we'll be converting it to degrees. Then we'll flip this value between negative 90 to 90 degrees to prevent any exaggerated movement or prevent any weird movements here. And for some values, and you have to pair the rotation vectors to either roll pitch or by yourself, and the value may be changed if you are using a separate one. So you have to check it and make sure that you pair the value right. And you pair the value wrong, you will have some weird movement here as well. And so lastly, if the connect argument is enabled, we will be sending the information, sending the detected roll pitch and as well as other facial expression values to the Unity one here, using the send to Unity function and the TCP connection. So you can press Q to leave, it's just the feature of the OpenCV here. So these are some of the arguments that we'll be using. So if debug flag is not enabled, then we'll be not showing the camera image here. And the connect is just to enable the connection of your TCP connection to the Unity. So here is a sample one, and you can see the detection works very well. The rotation works well, and so the three axes are some of the axes, and pitch and your pitch and roll and your as well. You can see it works perfectly. And so that's it, and this will be our first episode of the first video of this series. And thanks for watching. So make sure to check out the project in the GitHub, and the link is in the description. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it or enjoy the project, and you can share this video to your friends who are willing to build your own video and yet not willing to use some of the existing software like the face rig here. And I'll see you in the next episode, and stay tuned. Thank you, thanks for watching.